Everyone, salut à tous, this is Jordan of the band Dirty Wits and Horizon. Welcome on the Tour du Metal with DJ Sy on Metal today with Alex and Ralph of Primal Fear, the Hellfest. How are you doing, guys?
Pretty hot.
Thank you.
Pretty hot. Sweating.
Yeah, it's hot. How was your show today?
It was hot also.
Hot and fantastic.
Yeah, well, good fun. Yeah,
it's really good.
Okay, so you released your last album, Apocalypse, in August 2018. Can you tell us more about this upcoming album?
Yes, you can.
Yes, you can.
Because it's a new baby, so you can tell a lot about it. Yeah, we have had good fun recording it. We are proposing team, like five band members doing this.
Yeah. And
this is a great thing. It's a really good positive thing. If you have five creative heads in a band, then you are able to do a lot, create a lot, have a good system, how you work together, having this team effort, producing good music. So that's a good thing. And that happened in our conference. We really hear that we're somehow evolving on every album. We're really right now, we'll say, on the peak of our ability, how we work together since all these three years. And you can hear it on the album. The balance, the vibe, the diversity of the album is really something that keeps it interesting, and somehow nobody gets bored. So that's how it's always our goal. We have this quality game to produce good music, and that's what really happened on this album.
Yeah, like Ralph said, we have five writers in the band, which is a luxury.
Yeah.
And every writer has a different way of writing songs, a different style, so we can. We have the luxury, we can select out of a pool of songs.
Yeah.
And it's also a struggle, because then everybody wants his song on the album. So, but
so you're composing too much song, and then you select
not too many, but a lot, right?
Yeah. Yeah, we have 15 songs, and in the end it's going to be 12.
Yeah, maybe. So it's hard to give up on some of the songs.
But I said before in other interviews that we have 15 great quality songs, and it doesn't mean that these songs will never happen on any album, because sometimes you have to have conception, sometimes you have to have a red line in the album, and some songs just sometimes don't fit because maybe we have too much songs on D, too much songs on A or whatever, so we choose how the flow is on the album. And basically that doesn't mean that we have three songs left that they're never gonna be on any album.
Yeah. Isn't it hard to have a connection between the songs if there is not always the same composers on each song? To have the main theme or the same energy?
I mean, like I said, we try to have this balance and this diversity that we don't have like five speed songs after each other. We have to have this
dynamics. Yeah, we always try to come up with the most powerful guitar riffs, with the best melodies, and I said this earlier, personally I like music has dynamics, so it goes up and down and up and down, and on this album we have lots of dynamics and also silent moments and stuff, and this is also a trademark of Primal Fear, balance, and the long epic songs, so we'll find it all on the Apocalypse.
Okay, how would you describe your musical evolution since 1980s, 97?
Yeah, there's been a little bit of an evolution, we can say, because the way how we write is a little bit different. We're not sitting together anymore in a real studio for months. We are creating ideas at home. This has advantages and it has disadvantages. Of course, it's always great to work together as a team in a real studio, but it's not happening anymore because we are living in different countries.
Okay.
But we have developed a way how it works best in swapping files on the internet and still have the responsibility to bring everything together, which makes everybody happy in the end. Because first of all, when the band is happy, then of course the fans will be happy, because what we like, they basically also like.
So it's easier right now to live in different countries with the new technologies?
It is, definitely. There's no doubt about it.
Can you tell us more about the upcoming Apocalypse tour in Europe?
Yeah, Alex, you wanna?
Well, we're gonna hit the road. out by the end of September for 4 weeks together with Riot, which is a great package, and personally I think. And I've met the guys at the airport 2 years ago, and we were hanging in New York at the airport, and it was so much fun. So I'm totally looking forward to that. And yeah, 4 weeks in Europe. Then we come back for 1 week or 2 weeks, and then we go to Japan. From Japan, we fly over to Australia.
Oh, great.
Yeah, I think it's a very rare thing that heavy metal bands play in Australia.
Yeah, yeah,
of course. Or that a European heavy metal band plays in Australia. So, and this is the second time we are able to do this, which is kind of cool.
Yeah.
Back to Germany for Christmas, and next year the tour will continue in different countries all over the globe.
The special thing in Japan and in Australia is going to be Sinner and Crime of Fear, and of course the plan in Australia for the latest age. But I used to go to see the funeral was there. That's just a side note, but it's also maybe for the Australian fans. So it's going to make a good package.
Package too, okay. So it's been 20 years you've been active in the more heavy metal scene. How do you feel the evolutions for the scene?
Well, now I can always speak for myself.
Yeah.
It has always been the way that I, on one hand, don't care about it because I want to make music. I want to have a good feeling already on the album,
yeah.
And I would never hop on any trend.
Great.
She speaks. That's all I know.